to Whitley Strieber's podcast studio. I'm here today to do a retrospective discussion with Whitley about his book, Them. Now, Whitley, this is personal for me because of this book is how I met you. Yeah. I decided to do a book club with my UFO network in Seattle, where I live. And when I let you know about our book club, you decided to join the book club.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
And so this is a special book to me. This is a collective of stories. Can you tell me your process on how you decided which stories to highlight?
Well, what this is a book that's in two parts. The first part are letters that we received from members of the public after Communion was published, 11 of those letters. And the second part concerns the military experience of contact. The first part is about communication and about what the visitors do. And some of the things they do are really strange. One of the letters shows them trying to enable this lady by a step-by-step process to remember all of the details of the experience she's having. Because one of the things that happens to the human mind, especially when we grow up and become adults, becomes very difficult for us to remember things that we have no internal reference for. In other words, if you have a memory, if you have an experience that you've absolutely never had before, remembering that clearly is hard and maybe even impossible. And they obviously know this. Then some of the other experiences in this is some that we have to look at very carefully. There's one where the man apparently was being pulled out of his body, and another where a woman looked up in her living room and saw across the room these figures like on the cover of Communion. And the next thing she knew, she had 4 hours of time just missing from her life. And what is happening during that missing time? I've had missing time right here in this flat. And what happens during missing time? We have to find out. And we're not going to find out from them. They're not going to sit across the table and tell us, this is about a new world if we can take it. That means we figure it out on our own terms. And this book, Them, is an attempt to characterize the various ways they come into contact with us. And from that, we can build on that to build our side of contact, because nobody else is going to do it. We have to do it. The visitors probably can't do it. They can try, but they're obviously not succeeding or things would be different. We have to figure this out.
To me, it feels like as humanity, we need to build some sort of toolbox for ourselves that gives us these keys to unlock these mysteries. And so this book, it really was an exploration to me of my own personal thoughts of, okay, how are we going to build these tools? And a lot of it comes from discussing and sharing and talking about the different methods of, say, meditation.
Yes.
Or, other things that people have had experience with that has been successful.
Well, there are certain tools that I use, and I can describe one of the important ones, most important ones, right now. Back when I was a young man, back in 1969, I joined an organization that had a certain meditation process where you took your attention and you placed it on your physical body and opened your mind. And this was supposed to enable you to kind of wake up to a larger sense of the world around you, which it does. Mm-hmm. Then 1985 comes along and the visitors show up. And after a few months with them in this 86-87 period, I learned how important this method of meditation actually is. But I only know it's important. I don't know why. Then Annie passes away and things begin to happen. I'm at a conference about 2 months after she passed away. I went to this conference in Nashville where we used to have our Dreamland festivals, and it was with a guy named William Henry who does beautiful conferences. And I thought, this will be get me out of the house. And suddenly a woman walks up to me at the conference and says, I just heard Anne's voice in my ear tell me to tell Whitley that she can see me when he sits in the chair. That meant when I meditate, because I sit in a chair. In fact, sometimes it's this chair. when I meditate and I do this exercise of taking my attention out of my mind and into my body. And then I remembered something else. Back in the 80s, the visitors had said to me, I asked them why they came, as one of the rare times when I had some really rich communication with them, and they said, we saw a glow. And I thought, oh, that means the glow of cities. But then I realized in that moment at that conference, no, that's not it. Anne is seeing me when I'm in this state. That is what causes the glow. And what was happening is, I would do this every night. I've been doing this every night for nearly 60 years. And they would see this little glow in this cabin in upstate New York, and they got curious and came in, and that's how it started. And now I do it regularly, and it is the foundation of my relationship with them.
It's amazing, because I have another download that I've had is do what lights you up. And that's exactly
this lights you up.
Yeah.
Absolutely, it does light you up.
That's really fun. Whitley, thank you so much for sitting down with me and talking about your books. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Very grateful. And thank you for watching. We hope to bring you more.